tyre label was introduced as part of a big package of safety measures for passenger cars and commercial vehicles. Tyres in particular are things that are probably more difficult for consumers to buy, but therefore they need much clearer and impartial information.
We really welcome the new tyre label because it will give the opportunity to the consumer to have a better purchase decision for safer tyres and more environmental friendly tyres. We have invested to train, educate our sales force, our dealers, and also to test the portfolio of our product.
We will be supplied with the tyre label on all new tyres coming into our shops, and of course with promotional material and very important information explaining some more technical aspects about the tyre label.
We have more than 270 engineers and testing experts to grade and assess the portfolio. It's about 10,000 different tyre types that we have to test and be ready when the regulation is in place.
I think as a dealer it'll give me the chance to speak to customers, engage them and talk to them about the benefits of tyres and try and get away from just purely price.
EU tyre label will be introduced in November 2012. It will highlight three tyre performances: noise, wet braking and rolling resistance of the tyre.
The rolling resistance test is run in the lab on a flywheel. So we put the test tire on the wheel and we push it against the wheel with a certain force. The more the tires have a high rolling resistance, the more the car slows down.
If you have a tire with an A grading on rolling resistance versus a G grading on rolling resistance, there is about a difference of 7.5% on the fuel consumption. And if you think about that, over the lifetime of that tire, the consumer would save about 300 euros that he could use for the next purchase of a next set of tires, for instance.
The wet grip index test is a test that evaluates the tire's ability for road holding on a wet track. We have a test with a set of high-grade tires versus the car with the low-grade tires, and there is a big difference in stopping distance. If you take an A versus a G, that's an amazing 18 meters difference. And it's not only the stopping distance which is shorter, but if you were into an accident, then the impact speed with the low-grade tires would be much higher. So we run on a vehicle, at a given speed we enter the measurement zone, the driver switches off the engine, and then codes by the microphone. In that way we just capture the tire noise, which is what we need to grade the tire for the EU tire label.
You can only give consumers, I think, a certain amount of information. You absolutely don't want to overload them. So therefore, I think we focused on clear criteria that enable consumers to make an informed choice.
I must say all the criteria are important, but if there is one which is the most important for us, Goodyear Dunlop, is the safety parameter, which is wet braking. But there are much more than those three criteria.
Goodyear Dunlop tests over 50 different parameters. So the tire grades do not tell everything. That's why we recommend that people consider the grades, but they also look at the reputation of major tire manufacturers and that they take professional advice from tire dealers.
Our hope as a company is that the EU tire label will help the consumer to select the correct tire for safety and environmental impact.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.